In this video, we're going to show the proper technique for force calibration of the DMT myograph system. You will want your setup to be as close to experimental conditions as possible. Therefore, you will need your heat turned on and the temperature to be at your experimental conditions. You will want to use the same buffer that you will use during your experiments, and you will want the same volume in your chambers that you will have during your studies. To access the force calibration menu, you will go to the settings menu and then the force calibration menu. You will then select the chamber that you're going to calibrate, highlight it and hit enter. This will take you to the calibration menu, which is a 6-step menu, but you really only do a couple things. Step 1 tells you to follow the procedure in the manual, but instructions are also provided in the menu here. Hit next step. Step 2 tells you to place the calibration bridge and T-balance on the chamber. So we will place the calibration bridge over the chamber. And then we will take the T-balance and drop it into the chamber in the grooves of the calibration bridge. You want the T-balance to drop in behind the wire on the force transducer side, as close as possible to the wire without touching it. And then hit next step. Step 3 prompts you to turn the temperature on, which takes about 20 to 30 minutes, so it's best if you start this before you begin your calibration procedure. In this case, we are at experimental conditions, so hit next step. Step 4 asks you to make sure that the transducer reading is stable. In this instance, the reading is stable, but if it's going back and forth between two numbers, that's all right. You can give it a couple extra minutes, or you can go on. Step 5 asks you to place the calibration weight on the pan. You will need to place the weight on the back pan to kick the bridge forward. After you add the weight, give it about 10 or 15 seconds to stabilize. And then you can go to the next step. The reading should be right around 9.81. If that's the case, go ahead and hit next step to lock in the calibration. For more information, please refer to the DMT 620M User Manual or additional resource videos.